Hey, I had a conversation with a friend a few days ago about static analysis, and he said that it's not comfortable for him to work with a project with the repository where static analysis is so strict and has so many rules and demand so many changes every time he makes a pull request that his point was that professional developers, they don't need static analysis that much. That static analysis is more like a tool to make suggestions, recommendations, but definitely, according to him, not a tool for enforcing programmers to do something. And I completely disagree with that and decided to record it, explain that static analysis, in my opinion, is not a tool to amuse you as a programmer. It's not a tool to entertain you, to give you some funny information and maybe to educate you, even though it does all of that. But static analysis is the instrument to make your life harder, not easier, but harder. And not only you as a developer, but all developers in the project. The more problems you have with static analysis, the more troubles you experience when you push your code through static analysis steps and through, well, the build pipeline, the better for the project, but more difficult for you. And if you are a professional developer, then you enjoy having all these troubles in the project. Junior developers, they don't like static analyzers. They hate them because they don't understand them. They don't understand what they're for. They don't understand why so many troubles every time they submit some changes. But the more professional you become, the more you have to enjoy all this negativity coming back to your code from analysis tools, including unit tests, including coverage control, including maybe some other instrument, maybe code reviews. But static analysis is one of the most important elements of the build pipeline, which has to make your life harder, which has to annoy you, not entertain you. Because some people think that static analysis is something that you run. It gives you so many fancy tables, like spreadsheets, reports telling you where your code is not so beautiful. You look at these reports and you walk away and continue writing the code the way you were writing before. This is not what static analysis is for, even though many teams think that this is how it should work. No, static analysis is a controller, is a gatekeeper, is somebody who is telling you that your code is bad. Is somebody who is saying that no, we're not gonna merge your code because it's not good. It's not somebody who is looking at your code after you merge it and then telling you that it could be better or next time please write better. Static analyzer is not your tutor, is not your mentor. Static analyzer is your controller, is somebody who is blocking you. And the more it blocks you, the more annoying, like I said, the more annoying it is for you, the more fun you have to get from it. And if you don't get fun, if you don't enjoy, that means that you're not professional enough. So, the more professional programmers are, the more they expect static analyzers to be present in the project. And of course, the job of the project is to make those static analyzers as strict as possible. The job of the project, the job of the architect of the project, the job of the repository. So the repository has to protect itself by introducing those static analyzers. And programmers have to enjoy this process of fighting with static analyzers, of trying to break them, to go through them by making the code better. So if you have no fun, something is wrong with you. Thanks for listening. Stay tuned. Bye-bye.